What's happening, guys? Look, this is going to be one of, I guess, many vlogs that I'll start doing during this, obviously, COVID-19 outbreak. First things first, I hope you're all well, and I hope you haven't really been that affected by it. I hope everyone's keeping healthy and obviously doing the best they can in this difficult time around the world. Thoughts and prayers to anyone who's been affected directly, or whose family's been affected directly. It's not good, and I hope it passes soon. So, first things first, I just wanted to check in with you guys. Most of Australia at the moment is, or most, I guess, corporate sector people are working from home, or are not, because they're an essential service. My job is an essential service. I work for a very large company. It's a large company in the world. It's owned by a massive Japanese company. So I won't tell you the name for obviously privacy reasons, but my role is considered an essential service here in Australia. I shouldn't be working at the office, however, for the plain and simple fact of, obviously, you guys know that I have multiple sclerosis. Those of you don't, I'll give you a quick version of it. Basically, it means my immune system attacks my central nervous system, so my body is basically attacking itself. And more specifically, it's my immune system that's attacking my body. So basically, the treatment I'm on at the moment, which is a drug called Ocrevus, it basically suppresses my immune system. And this means that it makes it a lot weaker than what it should be as a normal, healthy human being for someone around my age. Now, this is great because obviously it enables me to lead a somewhat normal life in terms of obviously being able to move around, walk, things like that, and not struggle day to day, even walking from my car to my front door. So amazing. The downside of that is that because I am on an immunosuppressant drug, basically it has weakened my immune system so much so that if I get COVID-19, there's a high probability that it will be fatal to me. So it may kill me, but I guess, look, I'm a very optimistic person. So first things first, I will say a couple of things. One is, please, for those of you who are stressed out about the world and everything like that, do not let it consume you. Do not let it pull you into that deep, dark hole where everything's depressing and you're just not feeling great mentally, because you'll find that a lot of physical illnesses are a byproduct of mental illness as well. Now, that's something I've struggled with as well, mental illness, but obviously a lot better now than what I was. So take it from someone who's walked down that path. It's never a good thing. And if you are struggling mentally, you need to speak to someone about it sooner rather than later. Second of all, look, there's rules in place for a reason. Practice good hygiene. Make sure you're washing your hands. Make sure you're keeping social distancing. Make sure you're not out there partying with 10, 15, 20, 100 people and throwing hugs and kisses everywhere and high fives. Just for the meantime anyway, just make sure you practice all the things they tell you to do, such as the hand washing, the hand sanitizer, disinfecting stuff, and good social distancing. Good hygiene is never going to not help you in a scenario like this. So yeah, look, now that we've got that out of the way, as I said, I'm an optimistic person. I'm not going to live my life in fear and worry, because that will just make me sick, literally. It's no good for your mental health, it's no good for your physical health. Worry and stress and things of that nature, if you can avoid it, do, because they will do you no favours. Moving on. So I guess I wanted to reach out to you guys to find out what I can do for the channel and for you guys whilst this lockdown is happening and whilst obviously everyone's basically at home. Do you guys want to see me do some how-to videos on certain things? There's a very limited things that I can do at the moment. So, for example, I was going to show you guys how to change wiper blades, how to change Parker globes, things of that nature. But again, I don't know whether that's obviously insulting to you guys. To be honest with you, I wish someone had told me how to change Parker globes on my 34 before I got it. It would have helped. But look, it is what it is. So do you guys want to see some stuff like that? I mean, as I said, because of freight and everything else like that, parts that I've ordered and things of that nature have not come through. So my hands are tied in terms of what we can do. What I can do though is things like those little videos on how to do a few bits and pieces, and also obviously I can make a couple of more videos on the R34, specifically the GTT. Whipping around a track. I was also going to do a video on every R34 commercial they ever produced, which is pretty funny, to be honest with you. So let me know what you guys want to see. Leave me a like, leave me a comment, leave me a thumbs down, leave anything really, as long as I know that you guys have heard it. And obviously if you leave me a thumbs down, I know that obviously you don't want to hear me talk whilst I'm driving. So yeah, guys, honestly, we're in some pretty terrible times at the moment, but worrying about it and making yourself sick over it is not going to help anyone. So my hope for all you guys is that you're all keeping well, you're all keeping safe, and that this passes sooner rather than later. Again, anyone who's been affected, I'll pray for you. I don't know how many of my viewers believe in God and things like that, but I do believe in God and I do pray. It's helped me out of some pretty bad times. So look, guys, let's just all keep in contact. Let's just all take the time to be kind to one another and obviously just have a laugh and have a smile together. For those of you who don't follow me, I'll throw the link up of my Instagram now. You can follow some stuff on there as well. Which is good, I guess. And maybe that's another way for you guys to interact with me. If you ever have any questions or on anything, if you guys want to see some informational videos about the R34, R33, R32, specifically not the GTRs, more so the GTSs and GTTs and GTS 25Ts. Because look, GTR information and stuff like that, it's a dime a dozen. Everyone loves the GTR, we get it. But I more so want to rep the GTT fam. So look, I am going to be doing a how-to video shortly on basically replacing, so pretty much the R34 GTR V-Spec 2 and Z-Tune, I believe, came with a factory option, a standard, which is an aluminium bezel that goes around the speedometer and cluster. I've managed to get a hold of one of them through one of my, through a new company actually that's just started. It's called Tokyo Special. It's not on their website yet. They do a lot of Nismo badges and JDM t-shirts and hats and things of that nature. I'll throw the link up, or I'll throw it up in the screen as well as down in the description now. Obviously they're not paying me for anything, but I did just purchase a couple of t-shirts from them, which, well, we'll get here when they get here. So yeah, check them out. They've got some pretty cool stuff there. Free shipping to Australia and the US, which is a bonus, I think. So yeah, guys, honestly, enough rambling from me. Again, I haven't spoken to you guys in a little while, so I thought there was lots to say. I just wanted to check in. Again, there's 162 subs now, unreal. I think maybe 7 or 8 of them are family and friends, but the rest of you actually want to watch my stuff, apparently, which is great. So thank you so much, guys. I'm glad we can all obviously have platforms to come together and obviously share a bit of joy during this terrible time. But I'll leave it there, guys. So from me, goodbye, take care, and be safe.